so bad. So you're like holding it like this and just like shredding on it. Yeah. You can hear it.
On that thing with a cowboy boots and everything. Have you seen her play the frog?
Music review. I'm so glad to have you here with me and so glad to be invited into your living room tonight. As always, we have music for you that is entertaining, fun, and full of joy. Being that we're in the holiday season, I think it's important that we bring to the screen things that are all-encompassing, if that makes any sense. The ladies that you're going to hear tonight are different, they're fun, they're intelligent, they're beautiful. You've seen at least one of them on my show before, and they all three play ukuleles. Really? How's that sound? It sounds like fun, right? For the first time seen ever under this name, let me ask you to welcome into your living room, Baubo.
Thank you, Dad.
You're welcome.
Ready for us?
Hit it.
Okay,
let's do it.
Some bright morning when this life is over. Fly away,
Cool. Good stuff.
That's a real old song that we didn't write, but it's a good one. What do we do next?
You just go right into it?
Let's do it.
All right. Yeah. Okay. Ready, Grandma Dot?
I was ready.
I thought so. All right, this is a song about the circus. Like all good things, she's been maligned.
Damn everything but the circus. Damn everything, not behind the curtains. And keep your eyes on things way up high. There is always a woman who knows how to fly. Find your seat in the circle, you won't believe your eyes. There are clowns who act silly to hide. They are wise. And a clown's only problem, his solutions make new ones. He's got a wound as big as his shoes. Taught him to. Loved her better long ago. daughter do.
Jen Taylor original.
Pretty awesome.
Pretty awesome.
Pretty awesome.
The circus. And the kazoo factor there, too. Kazoo. Adds a little circus element to it. Nice. Thank you, Amanda Koulos. So we have Amanda Koulos down here at the end. Kazoo and Koulos, we like to call her. Anna May, ripping it up in the middle down here. And I forget my own name sometimes.
Yeah, it's a toughie.
Who cares? Anyway.
Anna May, do you want to do a song for us? One of your
sure.
specials?
Sure.
I'll do a very nice Anna May.
Should I break out
a new? And we're a new band, so we still use papers.
We still use papers.
And we were going to try to not use papers today, but we got here, and you had this nice music stand, so we were like, well, why not? We're
going
to take advantage. It's Grandma Dot's living room. I think the point is to be at home.
Absolutely.
Here, right?
Grandma Dot's attic.
Attic.
And you definitely
big
have
difference.
Be at home in an attic.
Definitely. Or you don't belong there.
Exactly.
Yeah, get out. You don't even know about Paddington's movie.
Yeah, just don't
even think.
I love attics, and I think you girls belong in my attic specifically.
Thank you. Oh. Thank you, Dot.
That sounds like a good place.
Okay.
Righteously.
I'm ready.
Track and back again.
You've seen sunrise and you've seen it set, but there's a lot of things you ain't seen yet. They call me sweet little inhibition, but you won't catch me in the crossfire of contrition. And we're a tricky little kind with our highway signs and our red wine. It's gonna go where it's gonna go, and where we run you don't need to know. Here we go now, sinking under this sickly spell of wonder. Underestimating my intelligence, but I wanna see you go and hop that fence. Heard you talking all that thunder, baby. Maybe listen closer to the wind. We've been around this track and back again. Every time you mess me around, I'm gonna blaze a trail and rise up from the ground. I'm gonna whip you into shape and see what kind of deal we can make. And in the end, we're all the same. We've all been a pawn in someone's game. And breaking loose, your lover is tangling the noose.
That was a first timer. I don't know what that's called yet.
All right.
Doesn't I love this? Songs that you don't have a name for yet.
Yeah.
That means that they're first here, too.
Yeah. No name, yes. And we were almost no name here as well.
Almost. I know.
But
we named you. You now we have name here before you came on the air.
Now we
so
have
that's
a name.
Awesome.
That was funny. I was working on the frog during your song, and she was just good. Kind of vibrating around the drum. I had to turn around like this.
I like it.
Just a moving frog.
She's a nice frog.
She hopped.
Yeah. As she should.
Yeah, frogs are nice.
Yeah, I like frogs.
Frogs are nice.
Frogage.
Yeah. All right. So, Ms. Dot, what do we have time for? Like
lots.
One more song?
Oh, no, lots.
So many songs?
What?
All the songs.
I want to hear.
Let us. That's what I want to hear.
All right, we're going to have Kazoo and Kulos take the lead here.
Kazoo and Kulos, sans Kazoo.
Unusual. But it happens.
Hmm. Propless, almost. All right, Lighthouse Keeper. I want to marry a lighthouse keeper and keep him company. I want to marry a lighthouse keeper and live by the side of the sea. I'll polish his lamps in the light of day, and ships at night will find their way. I want to marry a lighthouse keeper, won't that be okay? We'll take walks along the moonlight bay, maybe find some treasure too. I'd love living in a lighthouse. How about you? The dream of living in a lighthouse, baby, every single day. The dream of living in a lighthouse, the white one by the bay. So if you want to make my dreams come true, you'll be a lighthouse keeper too. We could live in a lighthouse, won't that be okay? Hey, hey, ya-da-da-da-da-da-da.
I like that song.
Thank you.
Dream a little dream.
Yeah.
Dream it up.
Yeah, yeah.
All
dream of me. Say
nighty night and kiss me. Just hold me tight and tell me you'll miss me while I'm alone and blue as can be. Dream a little dream of me. Stars fading, but I linger on, dear, still craving your kiss. I'm longing to linger till dawn, dear, just saying this. Sweet dreams till sunbeams find you. Whatever they be, dream a little dream of me.
This is new. New Amazon song. I think about them a lot. Can you shoot an arrow from behind your back? Can you ride a horse while you're doing that? Can you swing from a tree and catch yourself before you hit the ground or somebody else on purpose? Everyone knows we are Amazons. You think we're sexy and you'd rather get along than fight us. True story. Do you walk through the woods singing a song? Do you notice the light after the dawn? 'Cause I do. Do you button the shirt of the one that you love when you fill your belly? Do you think of the sun? It's not always easy to be me. The world is a kind of dystopian scene to an Amazon. Oh, I was attacked on the F train at 2 a.m. in the bowels of the subway station in Brooklyn. But one spinning Zima kick, the guy ran away, pulling his t-shirt over his face and screaming. Because everyone knows we are Amazons. You think we're sexy and you'd rather get along than fight us. Some chick from Texas stole my one cowgirl hat. I wish I knew where she kept it at. Some chick from Texas stole my one cowgirl hat. I guess she needs it, but I want it back. Queen Penthesilea invented the battle axe. And guess who actually invented pants? That's right, Amazons. The Greeks were obsessed with Atalanta. They sang of her more than most anyone. Did you know that? And do you walk through the woods singing a song? Do you notice the light after the dawn?
Heard the song about Atalanta? She's a famous Amazon.
Is that the one you did out at Wrestling Cats?
That was at Wrestling Cats that time.
Yeah. That was great. That was awesome.
Thank you. So, special heads.
What do you think?
Well,
we still have more songs, huh, Dot?
Yeah, you do.
She's like, go, go, go.
Yeah.
Woo! Go, go, go. Go, go. Okay.
Yeah. What do you guys want to do? Don't think twice.
Don't think twice.
Let's do that, yeah.
All right. Get that baby out.
Okay. Still using it. How do you text with those big nails, Dot? Are you using your nails? Oh, you're knuckling it over there.
I got
a knucklehead in the house.
Yes. I'm answering posts about you guys on
Instagram. Oh, really?
I love you.
What?
Brayden Sunshine's dad, Dave.
Yeah.
Said, love them.
He can already hear us?
He just said it's live. Because our cameraman posted a video.
Oh, come on.
See?
Such a lot of ties.
That's a
the sneak,
it's high technology here. High technology.
0 to fame in less than a minute.
Her name's Dot.
Thank you.
And Grandma
did it first. Grandma did it.
It ain't no use to sit and wonder why, babe, if you don't know by now. And it ain't no use to sit and wonder why, babe, it'll never do somehow. When your rooster crows at the break of dawn, look out your window and I'll be gone. You're the reason I am traveling on. Don't think twice, it's alright.
And it ain't no use in turning on your light, babe. That light I never know. And it ain't no use in turning on your light, babe. I'm on the dark side of the road. Still I wish there was something you would do or say to try to get me change my mind and stay. But we never did too much talking anyway, so don't think twice, it's alright.
floor. It ain't no use commanding, girl. I can't hear you anymore. I'm thinking and I'm wondering on the way down the road. I once loved a woman, a child, I'm told. I gave her my heart, but she wanted my soul. Don't think twice, it's alright. Walking down that lonesome road, babe, where I'm bound, I can't tell.
Some things we need to do. We need to shop local. It is the holiday season, whether you're celebrating just being alive, or Kwanzaa, or Hanukkah, or Christmas, or the season of the life, whatever you celebrate, and you should celebrate every day. Anyway, we need to shop local. There's some really great shops downtown, and the Hygienic Art Gallery has an exhibit going, small gift and art thing, and you can go in there and look at real art done by real people that are real local and buy real art to give for a gift. What an amazing way to hand out the love is to give a piece of work that was made by someone you know. So let's do that. Let's make this holiday season not about commercialism and big box stores and things. Let's make it about each other and about the music. I have these really amazing ladies here, so let's, you know what I mean. Hi, guys. I couldn't be more excited if I was naked, surrounded by a bunch of naked people.
Oh, my gosh.
Just wait, this is a family show. Oh, my. Where did you guys come up with this concept?
The kazoo ukulele concept.
Kubos, or, do you want to speak to that? And the three, and yeah. All of it.
Okay. I think you kind of stumbled across
I held my first kazoo a couple of months ago.
Really?
My friend Ben had a metal one. I blew into a couple times, and I it was just so silly. And it made me laugh so hard. And I was also learning ukulele. And one of my things, I do a lot of different things. And my dream is just to combine all of the things all of the time. So kazooking became a thing.
And, okay.
Yeah.
I can't believe that you just now in your adulthood played a kazoo, because we had kazoos when Grandma was a little kid.
It's a very grown-up thing, Dot.
It's a new old thing.
I don't know. It was a little kid thing back when I was a kid.
I've been told a lot of the
really
things
young.
I do are little kid things,
thanks,
and I just think they're grown up.
That's a good thing. I don't want to grow up. Isn't that a commercial for some big box store?
Beginner's mind, isn't that what the Buddhists say? Anyway, we're all trying to get there.
Yeah, we all want to just be a little kid inside. So, Anna, I've seen you perform with your dad. I've seen you perform kind of alone. How does it feel to be performing with two other women?
Oh, it's amazing. This is like the best thing ever. Like, so much fun. Yeah.
Right. You guys look like having a lot of fun up there. Yeah. Now, didn't you play at Nightingales just a few nights ago?
We did.
How
was
really that?
Fun. It was great. Yeah, that was 2 weeks ago. We had a lot of people in the house, a lot of fun, and
That's
really,
cool.
Really good.
Are you going to go on tour now?
Yeah, we're going to Vermont on Sunday. So
you
the
are?
Tour is
the
beginning.
Three of you?
Yeah.
Oh my goodness, do I want to be a flea on the wall of that trip? I'm going to get in the trunk. That's all there is to
Come
it.
On.
So it seems as though the three of you are just doing
in your life what you want to do to have fun. How does that transcribe into paying your bills? Just a little reality check there, guys. I know how it transcribes, but that's because I'm grandma. Tell me how this is transcribing into paying your bills.
Who do you want to answer
all
first?
Of you.
It's a tricky balance. I work full-time. I work for a company called ECDC. I work with disabled adults. I do my 40 hours a week, but I need things like this to keep me sane.
I agree.
Absolutely.
Well, I divested myself from the 9-to-5 corporate world a long time ago, and it was never really that corporate. I worked in nonprofit activist circles, so I worked for the Center for Reproductive Law and Policy, which is the right-hand legal arm of the reproductive rights movement. Mm-hmm. I worked for HIV Law Project, these kinds of places, and by about 31, 32, I really had enough of that. And the phrase, be the change that you want to
That's
see,
my line.
Is so trite, but it's so cool.
Tattooed around my ankle.
Right on.
Nice. Be the change that you want to see. I write it on Facebook all the time.
Yeah. So within the circles of activism, I found that, and you sort of knew this day was coming because everybody has burnout, but it was more than burnout. It was, I can't change anybody's mind by arguing with them, but if I present joy in a certain way, then I can get there. So you're talking to somebody, I got my degree in philosophy, and I went out and pretty much immediately started sort of hit the streets, you know, to sort of uncover.
With the joy thing.
To uncover, yeah.
That's why I like you so much.
Well, the body was hidden because here I am, and like the philosophy is very much about the classical canon, and the body has been excised from the classical canon, you know, starting with Aristotle and demoting the female to the, you know, the body and the male to the spirit, and this is a hierarchy, and the whole thing goes down from hill from there, and Augustine comes and chimes in a couple of centuries later, and we're screwed.
Right.
So the body has been excised from the classical canon, so I went looking for the body post philosophy degree.
Yeah.
And the body is, I found it in the circus. And I found it in the circus through trapeze and aerial work, and which is now, silks have now entered into the lexicon.
Yeah.
And this is...
And you actually teach that too, don't you?
And I teach that stuff, and this is about...
Is there a website or someplace that people can find you if they want to learn about trapeze work or the silks?
Yes,
the silks, some people don't know what the
people
silks
don't know,
are.
They're new, they're only 20 years old, it's a new thing, but they're silky and they
Isn't
like
that the thing
two ribbons.
That Pink did? Or
Pink
one
did
of those people.
Yes, she did. But she didn't really do it. She just kind of like
faked
hung
it.
Out in
yeah,
it.
Yeah,
yeah. And but everybody
but you really
knows
do
that
it.
Because of her. And anybody can do it. So my place is called Om. Om. Fly.
Om Fly?
Yeah.
Om.
Fly.
Yeah.
Dot org.
I don't think, yeah. I'm, yeah.
Yeah.
I'm interested, but you know how I feel about it.
So I followed the joy factor, basically, and I worked for public access television. I worked for Dyke TV for a couple years right after I quit the 9-to-5.
Yep.
There was no money in that.
Right.
And so I really went full-scale artist, and I eventually, through all of the community and activist work, ended up at a nonprofit that I don't draw a salary from, but I have a beautiful place that I live in exchange for the work of running the place. And then I run the circus school, teaching trapeze and silks, and I get to do my music.
See, that's
so
awesome.
It really, it is for, it's do what you love, and the money will follow.
Well, you
it's
know,
not an easy, fast road, though. And be prepared to not have a lot of money.
I went to that place back in 2012. And in 2010, I realized that the life that I was living was really wrong. Really, really, really wrong.
2012?
Yeah.
Okay.
Really wrong. And
how wrong,
I,
Dot?
Yeah, and I decided to follow my joy, because my grandmother had always, she didn't say money. She always said, "Follow your heart, and the riches will follow." She never said money.
Right. So that's
my grandmother never worked out of her home a day in her life, and she never stopped singing, and she was always taking care of her shut-ins, which were usually younger than her, and she never stopped being happy ever. And she had a grumpy husband and rotten kids, and she was the most amazing woman I ever met. Follow your heart and the riches will follow. So I get that. And I've been doing that. I'm dead broke, but I've never been happier in my life. So I totally get it. Yeah. Now tell me what you're doing.
Following the joy factor, definitely. Yeah, I mean, I had like an awful like
school for me, like I knew right away, I'm like, I'm not a 9-to-5 person. This is not right. gonna, I can do it. I definitely have the capacity to get in there and, you know, be disciplined and do my thing.
Oh, I'm but sure
I
you do.
Just good brain.
Yes, she does. Yes, she does.
But I always kind of, and my mom was really good about that. I need to offset that side of myself with, you know, something that's, you know, much I think I was
artsy
meant
and
to do.
Well, your dad has encouraged you a lot too, and he's extremely talented.
Yeah, yeah. And just, yeah, so from a young age, like just traveling, living different places, meeting people, and I think, yeah. And
so
maybe I'll shift the other way and do like a corporate job when I'm older. I don't know. But I don't think so. I think I'm going to stay on this path. And yeah, like, you know, things, it's easier.
It's good to do a little insider anthropological investigation from time to time.
Well, I think if I have to work in the, quote, corporate world, it's in the same kind of field that you work in. I've done that off and on
social
for 30
services,
years.
Yeah,
working with people that need me more than I need them.
And don't get me wrong, I have fun at work. I
taught
kazoo lessons the other day to my clients. We
that would be so much fun.
You saw the video.
We have fun.
Yeah.
You saw the video?
Yeah, there is video.
I think you should post it up on my Facebook page.
It is beautiful.
It would be awesome.
Yeah. Yeah.
I think that's wonderful. I think that what you guys are doing is amazing. I think that some of the songs that you do need to be done with kazoo. A couple of them are kind of heavy songs, but when you do them with ukuleles and kazoos, it kind of... I'll Fly Away is not a happy song.
Not a happy song.
It's a very, very, very old gospel song, and it's about dying. So, you know, for you guys to like...
I'm not having a very free life before the death moment.
Right, right, right. Flying away from what you had going on here and that being the happy point.
Yeah.
I'm down with that. I get it, but... Yeah, not a good thing. So where do you guys want to go from here? Now you're here on my show, and already people
want to
go
to your attic.
We'd
like to
go.
Yeah. You have to get out of bed really early in the morning to come to the real attic. And that's, yes, you do. You've done that.
I have done it. And he took a picture of me, and I was, oh, man, I thought I was on the radio. I had, like, rolled out of bed.
It was funny.
It was really funny. It's funny.
Well, because when I get up to do my radio show, it's early in the morning, and she wasn't awake yet. And
no, not this
dad,
early in the morning.
It was dad, and they both were on the show, and yeah, it was pretty funny. But they still sang. And your new CD is really good.
Thanks.
It's really good.
It's old news now, though. That was like a
Well, it's kind of old news, but it's really good.
Thank
and
you.
It's not getting the kind of airplay I'd like to see it getting. So that's we can slide that in if you guys want to come do the radio show. But so you see, now that your new name.
My favorite song of anime is 395. Do you know that one, Dot?
It's my favorite as well.
That's my least favorite of my songs.
Really?
Yeah.
But don't you guys like all know each other's music a little bit too? You're all kind of each doing a solo here and there, and you all kind of do your music and your music and your music. So you're all kind of mixing up all of what you do. Which one of you thinks you're the best songwriter?
Now you're appealing to our egos.
Yes. Egos are good.
Yeah. Well, this one obviously is the best songwriter.
Yeah, I think Amanda.
And you want to know
no
why?
Question.
No.
Because I haven't written a single song. That would be one.
You know what?
Clear.
See this?
See that?
Mm.
Yeah, it's working.
That was mean.
Working.
But it's good.
Noggin.
Yeah. Oh my God. You know, if we had a bottle of wine sitting here, this would be even worse. So we're coming into the holiday season. Are there gigs coming up for you guys that are going to bring the joy of your threesome to the public? Do you have any things coming up that people can see you do?
I hope we bring joy this holiday season,
yeah.
You know, but I want to bring joy all year round.
Absolutely.
Me too. But do you have any gigs lined up?
We do this Friday in Chester Center.
That's tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
Which was yesterday.
Which was yesterday. My gosh.
Oh,
yeah.
Right.
Oh, that's confusing.
So that doesn't work. After that?
After that?
Burlington, Vermont? At the radio
beam. You guys are going to Burlington, Vermont. You'll have a DVD to take with you to take to the public access station up there.
Oh.
So that will be awesome. In going to Vermont, in Burlington, are you going up there with Bill? Are you going to run into Bill?
Don't know.
Bill, I don't remember his last name right now because I'm thinking, but
I always remember things when I don't think myself.
Well, no, really. Yeah. I have too many things going on here, and when they're all going on at the same time, then there's nothing. Sorry, but that's just how it is. It all comes out the end of my fingernails.
Thank goodness. Those are nice fingernails.
Yeah, they are. But while you're traveling and spreading yourselves out, do you intend to sit down in a circle and write some things together? You being the consummate songwriter of not having written a song,
hey,
and best. You being the songwriter that writes circus songs and Amazon women songs, and you that has just been writing and writing and writing and writing because you can't stop writing, and you told me that when it comes in your head, you have to write it down. See, these are things I know. Do you think that together, the three of you can sit down and actually write some music together? Or do you think that that's not the kind of writing that you guys want to do?
Having never written a song, I feel like with these ladies, I feel like something could happen.
Yeah.
There are thoughts flowing. There are things happening here.
Yeah, there's definitely a triangle of power going on here that's really cool, and you guys need to work with that. Triangles are really powerful, and you need to keep doing what you're doing with that. So I know that you have at least one song to go out with because you've promised me that. I'd like you to give out each of you places where you can be found if you want to be, like Facebook or websites, and then I'm going to let you go back to, after you give out your things, and ask you one little more question after you give out your addresses, and then you're going to go back and play us a takeout song. So where can we find you?
I am unsearchable.
I like that.
At this moment, I am,
Okay, well, maybe you guys have to create a Baubo page.
Yeah, I mean, this is so new. The name, this is our first day under this name.
I know,
so
I think that's what I wrote on Facebook.
It's happening, it's happening.
It is.
She's, Baubo is a Celtic, pre-Celtic frog goddess who assisted in childbirth and labor and these kinds of things.
And other things. Bob pulled it up on his
other thing. Kinds of special things. She was really great at subversive humor.
Right, she was the humorist.
She was very humorful. Yeah, she was the only one who could make Demeter laugh when Persephone was kidnapped by the dirty uncle, Hades, that story.
Yeah, so where can people can people go to a website to find out about flying?
They can. Fly.org.
Okay.
So they can find all about just sort of my pedagogy and philosophy around circus and as metaphor for life, as well as actual play and physical activity.
Okay.
And then Facebook, just Jen Taylor on Facebook.
Jen Taylor on Facebook. And Anna?
Yeah, mine's like facebook.com/animefolk, youtube.com/animefolk, and anime.bandcamp.com, I think.
Sure. And if you go to animebandcamp.com, you can get her new CD, which isn't really new anymore, but it's really awesome. And that comes from me, and I don't say it's awesome if it isn't. You know that. You know I don't say it's awesome if it isn't, and it's a great CD. Are you doing any things around with your dad anytime in the upcoming future?
Yeah, I think on Saturday I'm going to play with him. Today.
Tonight.
At Smart Vineyards. I think it's like 4 to 7.
That's already all over.
It's all over.
Oh,
gee.
You step into MetroCast. What happened?
Right. Well, see, because people are getting used to this because we tape a few days early so that we can get the sound right and stuff. When we come into this show that we are taping live, then it's weird. It's weird, but we get through it. And you guys are awesome, and you're wonderful, and you're fun, and you're full of love, and you're full of joy. And I want you guys to take us out with the song.
I forgot. I have a Bandcamp page, too.
Okay.
Yeah. And a Reverb Nation. I have two albums that are on the Bandcamp page.
That I don't have any of, so I can't play them on the radio. Yeah, and if you bring them to me, I'll play them on my radio show.
They're really awesome.
I can't wait. Take us out with the song, ladies. I love all three of you. You're amazing. You're wonderful.
You,
your music is fabulous. Have a wonderful holiday season.
Thank you, Doc.
Joy.
Thanks for having us.
Yep. Watch your tide. Yeah. So while they're going back, let me get back here. Hi guys. So, yeah. Oh, you're over here. I thought you were here and you're over there. Hi, guys. So these ladies are amazing. I hope you've enjoyed the show. It is the holiday season. Please remember to shop local. If you're looking for someone to give something to, the Guard Art Center is doing, because of the Joseph and the Amazing Technicolor coat, they're doing a coat drive, and you can just go there if you want, if you can go to the Guard Art Center and find out more about there. But those coats will all stay in our community, and they are for our community, and any gently used or brand new coats can be brought to the Guard, and you can also get tickets for Joseph's Amazing Technicolor coat. And that will be fun. So I'll see you guys out and about. Love each other. Until then, remember, the smile that you give away today may be the only smile somebody sees. Until next week, God bless. Bye-bye.
We got married in a fever, hotter than a pepper sprout. We've been Jackson Town. Go on down to Jackson. Go ahead and wreck your head. Play your hand, you big talking man. Make a big fool of yourself. Yeah, go to Jackson. Go comb your hair. Honey, I'm gonna snowball Jackson. See if I can.
When I breeze into that city, people gonna scream and bow. All those women gonna make me teach them what they don't know.
times.